The car industry is booming, but a surge in demand is straining dealerships across the country after a microchip shortage during the pandemic disrupted their supply of new cars. Tonight, our Frankie Katafias continues her coverage of how it's affecting small, locally owned dealerships.
During a normal year, you'd find almost 200 cars lined up at fairly reliable Bob's. But this year is anything but normal.
Right now, we're probably about 90.
Increased demand for cars in the past year have kept dealerships busy. But with new cars in short supply, dealerships like Fairly Reliable Bob's have struggled to increase their inventory.
We have more people coming in to buy cars than we have cars to sell them.
Bobby Peterson says used cars today are selling for nearly double their actual worth.
On an average car, especially an inexpensive car that used to sell a year ago, let's say, for $2,000, that car is going to be $4,000 now. And in the more expensive ones, it's even a bigger gap.
Bobby used to buy anywhere between 10 to 13 cars each week from auction. Now he's only taking home 2 to 3.
Because of the pandemic, the new car guys didn't have as many cars, so they weren't taking as many trade-ins. And because they couldn't get new cars, they were hanging on to their used cars or even going to the auctions and buying used cars that we would normally buy. So now we're competing against the big boys.
And adds, even if he could purchase his usual amount, he wouldn't.
We don't want to load up too much because if the prices do come down dramatically, like they went up dramatically, we don't want to have too many cars, you know, that we paid too much for.
And while his inventory is lower than usual, he does carry some of the more coveted cars.
People come in hoping to get a pickup, and they're surprised by the lack of choices, you know, and we're doing the best we can. Believe me, we are working really hard.
In Boise, I'm Frankie Katafias for Idaho News 6.
Bobby tells Idaho News 6 his dealership isn't feeling the direct impact from the microchip shortage yet, but is preparing for potential impacts this fall.